Hi guys, welcome to the second video of the Food Forest Workshop. You know, if you haven't seen the first video, go back. It's there, it's been recorded. Just go back, follow that, because it's real great content there. I'm going to follow up with this one here. First video, we spoke about the magnificent system nature is, the power of the forest and how abundant and how powerful that is. And then we went on to say, you know, we've organized this system where we can produce crops in it and use this power to make it economically, you know, viable in the civilization that we live in today. Right, so we're going to be in this video discussing some of the basic principles, some of the most important principles that you'll then be able to go ahead and apply straight away in your home garden or if you're a professional farmer in your professional food production system.
Yeah, that's great. So we're going to walk through five basic principles that we consider. These are the core of agroforestry system, and these are to be applied to any system of production that you choose. Like we said earlier, you can produce grains, vegetables, animals, whatever it is. The principles are the same and are applied in the same way. First of, and this is the principle that I consider most important, and it actually, all the other principles, they nurture from this principle, which is the optimization of resources and energy, which is the basic strategy nature uses in order to create richness, to create more life and to enrich itself. And we've got lots of resources around us. Sometimes we don't even realize the amount of resources and abundance we have around us, right?
Yeah, sometimes we even wrongly, unevenly label weeds and things like that, and we don't realize it's a resource, you know, like, because every being is equipped to fill its purpose and leave a positive note. So sometimes we're judging a resource, what's a real powerful ally, as a problem. And you know, if we understand the nature and what it's doing there, we understand that we can use it as a resource.
Most certainly,
everything is here for a purpose.
And, exactly,
you know.
So, you know, where some people see a field full of weeds and they want to kill the weeds, we see gold, right? It's gold for us. It's material that we're going to use to nourish our plants, to nourish the microorganisms of our soil. Where some people see the leftovers of a banana tree after they harvest the fruit as a problem they have to deal with, we see it as food for microorganisms of the soil. We see it as mulch for our soil. So it's really a matter of tuning in and training our mind to see things as resources, and everything around us is a resource. And then when we move to the other principles, you're going to see that each principle is the optimization of a resource. First principle, stratification. The forest works in a stratified way, right? We've got layers of trees on the forest.
Yeah, and it's very important because through this we can fit in more mass, more green mass, more photosynthesis per meter square. Because if we respect the layers, you know, we can have trees a meter apart from each other but at different heights and at different times as well, you know. So if we can understand the stratification, we can promote more photosynthesis, more life in the soil.
In the same area.
More biodiversity.
Exactly. And that optimizes the use of space. Because where you had one, now you have two, or three, or four, or five species. Right? We're optimizing the use of space. Next one, let's optimize the use of time, a very precious resource we have. And we do that by using the succession of species, which is a principle that happens in nature. You have groups of species dominating an area at different periods of time, and these groups evolve. So we use that a lot in agroforestry, right?
Yeah, and we use it not only for the trees, but we use it in the veg, you know. So we're using it from the very first month of your forest, your crop, when everything is all small seedlings. So we start playing with the timing and the spacing of the veg, just as we do for the trees, for the longer terms.
Exactly. So in the same place, Once you prepare the soil to plant, you can have plants that will last 30 days, plants that will last 3 months, plants that will last 10 months, plants that will last 2 years, 10, 50, 1,000 years, all planted in the same prepared bed.
In the same meter square.
Exactly.
Just respecting the times and the spacing that each of them occupy throughout.
Now to the fourth principle, and this is an important one. Some people take a while to really understand the importance of this, but nature works like that all the time. Planting in abundance. High density planting of seeds. A cashew tree releases thousands of cashews throughout its life. Some of these are going to sprout, but after all of these cashew seeds that were released by the tree, two or three are going to become mature trees. And this is a very important means of genetic selection that nature uses. Yeah. And we defend that. We should use that in our
field. Once we plant in abundance, we give the opportunity of planting in abundance. We step out of that human zone where we're so ignorant, where we think we know where this tree is going to thrive. You know, it's like, I planted you here. Damn you, you got to grow here because I said so. So that's so far from the truth. It's the most ignorant thing we could have ever done. So if we've planted it in abundance, we're letting them, the species that we planted, decide and communicate to us where it belongs, where it's the most appropriate place for that specific tree. So if we planted 100 seeds, you know, and we've got 2-3, that's when you got to get your 2-3 blessed, long-lasting, you know, ill-free tree.
That's definitely true. And we always plant lots of trees by seeds in agroforestry system. And that's a major key important principle. It doesn't matter what you produce. If you add systematically, if you add bunches of trees, seeds, that's a great addition to your field because trees really pump up the health of your system. And then we go to the next principle, which is especially important when you are a commercial scale producer, right? Mm-hmm. Because agroforestry can become very, very, it can be very diverse. You can have a huge diversity in a small space, but that can be complicated when you're doing a commercial scale production, right?
Yeah. So we really try focus on a main crop, you know. We're doing agroforestry system, we're planting trees, abundance of varieties, but we're planting things that are adapted to serve this main crop. We are going to have like extra incomes from
secondary crops,
Crops and that, but we really make everything work for that one main crop. You know, we prune them in the right time of the year to benefit that one crop. So, and then by doing this, we're able to, you know, come in with machines and tractors and mechanize it. Yeah. So we can really go large scale on that as well.
We really optimize all the work, all the human labor and the use of machinery. And that is different if you are just doing agroforestry in your garden for your home consumption. Because then it's all right to have, and not only all right, but you want to have huge diversity in your garden so that you have various foods, various fruits, various vegetables. Right, because you want to eat a diversity of food in order to keep your health.
Yeah, and that's really important as well, you know, that each one of us, you know, maybe this is not what we have as a profession, but each one of us take the responsibility and be brave enough to produce in the space you have in your garden, if it's the case, and you can have a very beautiful garden. You know, it doesn't have to just be all lovely, colorful plants. You can have all lovely, colorful fruit. So you can really have an edible garden and have it all lovely and jolly.
Exactly. So you can see that the system is going to adapt to your lifestyle, to what you want to produce, to where you are in the world, because some species that work for us here might not work for you because you're in a different climate zone, and to what kind of scale of production that you're going to dive into. But the system, and this we're going to reinforce a few times still, is adaptable to any situation possible. Okay. So these are the main principles, right? This is a very quick overview of the principles. and now you might be wondering, all right, so I can see that, but then how do I actually go from knowing the theory to applying it to my garden? Because now I know stratification, but then how, where does each plant fit? How do I know? How do I actually apply that? How do I optimize all these resources you mentioned? How do I put that into practice?
So in the next videos, we're going to be talking about some of the main techniques that we're going to be applying now that we know these principles, okay? So stick with us, and I hope you've enjoyed it. Give us a thumbs up, thumbs down. Let's talk about it. Let us know what you think, okay? So from the Agroforestry Academy crew,
we're signing out. Catch you later.